Welcome.
Thank you and good morning. Morning.
Morning.
That doesn't sound like a good morning at all. So good morning.
Morning.
Sounds much better. So why are we here this morning? We're here to celebrate you. We're here to celebrate the achievements of the sponsors, of those who collaborated in such an important endeavor. That's why we're here. So I stand here to celebrate you. Today, St. Vincent de Grenadines celebrates the work of girls in ICT, as we join with the region in participating in the global initiative of empowering girls in this field. This we do with the hope that girls would see the many available avenues open to them as they contemplate career opportunities. As we convene today, I'll use this opportunity to give a synopsis of some of the things that has been done through the ITCD to empower girls in ICT. Since 2012, St. Vincent and Grenadines has partnered with the International Telecommunication Union to celebrate International Girls in ICT Day, celebrated the fourth Thursday in April each year. Just to give you a bit of statistics, over 357,000 girls and young women have already taken part in more than 11,000 celebrations of International Girls in ICT Day in 170 countries worldwide. Now this is a remarkable accomplishment. The main goal of Girls in ICT Day is to make girls and young women aware of the vast possibilities offered by ICTs and give them the confidence to pursue ICT studies and careers. In addition to focusing on girls, the initiative aims to raise awareness among parents, teachers, and other persons who influence the lives of girls. Over the years, ITSD has organized visits to business places for Form 3 and 4 female students, conducted workshops in Central Leeward, Bekwe, and the Union Island. In excess of 1,000 young women have had the opportunity to interact in different departments and business places during the past 7 years. At this point, I would like to thank all those business places and departments that saw the vision and came on board. A mobile application development training for young women, and the ITSD has also collaborated with the Gender Affairs Division within the Ministry of National Mobilization, Social Development, Family, Gender Affairs, Persons with Disabilities, and Youth. It sounds like an extremely large ministry. Note that we have been working across ministries to ensure that the gospel of ICT is preached. Women play a key role in the reduction of poverty and the promotion of social and economic development for themselves, their families, and their countries. Hence, we seek to empower you in the era of ICT, as it is an essential tool that can aid your social and economic development. As government ministries, national ICT regulatory agencies, regulatory authorities, ICT companies, academic institutions, UN agencies, and NGOs around the world are all encouraged to join the global effort and celebrate International Girls in ICT Day. I would like to thank these 5 countries that have come together for the second year to embrace our girls, who I believe will become the face of ICT in the region. Girls, it is my wish that you will grab all available opportunities to you as we move forward in a world where conventional jobs are becoming obsolete and jobs in ICT sector become more accessible. You must no longer feel inferior to your male counterparts. Go out, show the world what female power can be like as you strive to improve your lives, your schools, your community, your world. And I'd like to leave you with a short poem as well. The floodwaters of change is flowing, and our nation is truly growing. Stars shine brightest on darkest nights. Today is the morning when we all take flight. To work with the mind at hand without breaking rules. ICT is a gateway to the future bright. So let us all not be afraid to shine our light. So shine your lights this morning. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Can we get up? We're not going to delay much further, much later. Okay, and we can't do these photos without our representative from CAPS. And also, Ms. LaFleur, could you join us quickly? I promise we're not going to delay you so much further, Mr. P.S. Wait, so you know what? We should be having some of our girls also too, because this event is not about us. I want one table of girls to come. Quick, 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 quick. LaFleur, can you stand to the side for me so we can see the banner? Come, we need to have our tall lady. You're not going to stand with me over here? Beautiful tall ladies. You can stand in front of me. Yes? Okay, this is really it now. We release you. Thank you very much. Okay, guess what, P.S.? I lied. We have one shot that we would like to get. So one of the things, can you go with Mr. Ramdas for me? He's going to give you direction. Curtis? We're going to have P.S. stand in the front here, and Ms. LaFleur, can you stand in the front also? That actually, the back is now the front. So ladies, we want you to all stand up. Stand up, and you're going to be facing forward. Anil, are we? Okay, and then everybody, all our teachers, everything, can you stand? You can come back further, and I'm going to give a simple I'll give it Raj. I'm going to give a simple explanation. So we need to have, our cameraman is up nice and high. So guess what now? We are, as our PS has explained, a part of a larger global effort that's taking place. And within the ITU, this program, Girls in ICT, also is about this. So everybody has to do this. It's about making girls equal, like an equal sign. Can you take PS's folder for him? There you go. So that is about making girls equal. Can we get the RSC team in front, please? Girls equal with guys, with men, in terms of equal access to the internet. Is everybody doing it, photographer? Are you happy? No, PX. We don't like. Thank you very, very much. Okay, so let me just give you a little bit of that context. Thank you everybody for participating. So equals is the overall program that we are a part of, and that is to ensure, as I said, that girls are equal with, or women, females are equal with males in terms of access, use, creating content on the internet, all of that, creating ICT content. So that's what you guys are going to be doing today. Yes? Okay, nobody can be shy in this room. I know we don't have any shy people, right? So, can you, Mr. Ramdas, if I'm permitted to do this, while we're setting up, I just want to get a little bit of a tip from you in terms of what your solution is. Okay, no, I'm not going to get that. What I'm going to ask you to just say is whether you're doing GBV or CC. CC, climate change, GBV, gender-based violence. And this is like a bottle top and it's
gender-based violence.
Speak louder.
Gender-based violence.
Okay, gender-based violence. We have one team working on gender-based violence, and we have
gender-based violence.
Second team, gender-based violence. Excellent. And do we have our ladies from GSS working on?
Gender-based violence.
Very good. Gender-based violence. And we have?
Gender-based violence.
Wow. This is like, wow. Everybody is doing GBV. Let's hear what the Bekwe ladies are doing.
Gender-based violence.
Jeez. It definitely really is. This is fantastic. That means that we're going to be getting a lot of strong, important information.
Climate change.
Hey. Climate change, we need a clap for climate change. Climate change is taking place here. We have a mixed team here.
Gender-based violence.
Gender-based violence also. And what school are you?
Emmanuel High School, Mespo.
Can't hear you.
Emmanuel High School, Mespo.
You know, you're speaking quiet when you're speaking in a mic and we can't hear you. And you ladies are from?
Emmanuel, Mespo.
And what are you working on? Gender-based violence or climate change? If it's neither of them, are you a visiting team, observing team?
Yes, please.
No, I'm an observer.
I'm an observer.
All right, guess what? What's your name?
Camille.
There you go. Camille is an observer. And we have what school here?
Mountain View Adventist Academy.
Mountain View MVAA, some cracking people who have me under pressure writing, Nicole, what is this, blah, blah, blah. Welcome, ladies. Are you excited to be here?
Yes.
No, let me say it again. Are you excited to be here?
Yes.
Okay. And our girls here, what school are you from?
Jackson Secondary. Jackson Secondary.
Okay, that's JSS. GSS. Okay. Welcome, welcome all. Did I do everybody's table? If I didn't do a table, raise your hand. Let me see. So I did everybody's table. Welcome. Oh, we have a new team that is coming in just in time. So can you tell us what school you're from?
GHS. St. Vincent Girls High School.
St. Vincent Girls High School. Everybody is going to welcome them. Okay, you want some cool water to drink, right? Yes, please. Okay, we're going to get some water for you. Welcome, girls. And once you just catch your breath, we're going to invite you to come down so that you can get your t-shirts, so that we can get going. Okay? All right. So I think we have, how many teams do we have here now? We have a good set of representation. So we are about to kick off Caribbean Girls Hack. We have for you today a number of different tech expo type activities that are being led by our C Tech clubs from out of Trinidad and Tobago, and they are also across the Caribbean. So you'll be doing everything from green screen activities. What is this one here, Anil? That one?
That's games.
Games, that is gaming. Then we have robotics that is taking place, hair robotics that mean we're not having anybody with heads on the table because we're all engaged, right? And over here, what do we have over here? Simulation exercises, Amrit is telling us. And then what we have down at the back, Amrit? Another aspect for gaming and simulation. So you can see that but I tell you something, it's really the observers that we have that for. While you guys who are on the teams are going to be hacking. So yes, you can actually go and see some of it because we know you want to see some of that as well and to engage and do some of that. I know that our representative, our director of gender affairs, Ms. Kwame Harry, is very happy to hear, right, the amount of teams that are going to be working on gender-based violence, but also the teams that are working on climate change and resilience, because all of those are aspects that you're going to be looking at issues which are very key for our Caribbean women. So everybody can see over here. I think this is the Anil, is this St. Vincent that we're looking at over here? Yes, we're looking at St. Vincent over here, but then you guys don't need to look at that because you actually know it, right? It is St. Vincent and the Grenadines. You one island people, like Jamaica, need to know. That's for me. Okay. But you guys know all of what that looks like and you have experienced that. Okay, so what I would love to hear a little bit about is some of Mr. Ramdas, where am I at? What some of your expectations for today might be like? Some of your expectations for today? Can anybody tell me what some of their expectations for today might be like?
Learn new things.
Learn new things, okay. I think we are ready to start, so I only have time enough to ask one more person.
Create new things.
Create new things. Give me a high five on that. Oh, all right. Okay, we are ready to kick off. Guys, we are ready to get started. So you're going to be working on your hacking solutions, but you're also going to be doing your pitches. So what we have over here at this side of the room is, ladies who are our judges, can you just raise your hand? Our judging panel, you see those ladies there? They look very nice. These are kind ladies, we can tell. They are going to be very kind. So what they're going to do is you're going to go to our judging panel and you're going to share with them what your solution is about, what you've created and that kind of thing. Show that to them and they're going to give you feedback. So remember, for this first part, it's not any you're not getting scored for it. You're getting feedback so that you can go back to your hacking station, which is your desk, your table, and then you're going to be improving your solution. Okay, how does that sound? Yeah? Okay, so I think, who wants to start? I think these ladies look, oh, these ladies are ready to start. So let's have the first table up. What school are you? Emmanuel High School. Okay, judges, you can walk around this way here, down there. So you're carrying your solution. So are you going to show them the solution on the phone? Or are you going to show it on a tablet? They have the information already? Okay, super. All right. So as soon as they're finished, we're going to come back and we will have another team. Can I see a show of hands for all of those who have something that they want to get feedback on this morning? Okay, one. Who else has something they want to get feedback on? Two. Any other teams have an idea that they want to get feedback on? No? Three. All right. So we have three more teams that are coming up. RSC, we have three more teams that are going to be coming up after this to get feedback from the judges. Oh, there's another panel here. So we can have panel group two already starting. Thank you, Akeem. So ladies, would you like to get started? But you need to get your t-shirts. So let me give you a little time to Get comfortable. Who was our second team? All right. What school are you again? Don't mind how many times I'm going to ask that question. Okay. MVAA, can you step here? And I think our mentors are ready. These mentors are very kind looking ladies. There's Natalie over here. They're not going to sit. Nope. They'll stand. Because okay. See, Natalie ready. Natalie's excited. Natalie said, what are they gonna be sharing with me? Okay. So you can put your laptop here or you have your connection ready. Connection ready, okay, super, excellent. So Mr. Greaves, you see we're kicking off with two schools presenting their pitches. And what are your expectations from them today?
For the girls to have fun and enjoy yourself.
Exactly. You heard that? So everybody will want to see a smile. I know that our Bequit ladies are tired because they had to wake up so early. But that means we're going to get some zinger presentations from the Bequit ladies, right? Okay. All right. So you will actually be able to go here after for the presentation, the other presentation, and we'll take the other team over here as well because since we have two judging stations. Okay? All right. And I won't ask you what school you're from because I remember. Thank you. You know the bathroom is downstairs. As soon as you go down the stairs, to the left is a bathroom. If you want, you can also put your t-shirt on over your school shirt, you know. That's another option as well too. Thank you.
You guys are between five, doing one all together, and you have Celebrate with us Girls in ICT Day on April 25th. And whatever you're truly passionate about, put technology at the heart of your career ambitions.
I'm not hearing any answer. You need it or you don't need it? Yes, you don't need it. So we're going to move this out of the way.
Can you help me?
Come on. We're going to move this out of the way and we're going to get started with our first team. Let's start with the first team that has the farthest to go. Bekwe? Let's hear. Yes, the whole room clapping for Bekwe coming up. Bekwe team is coming up. Not just the team captain, you know. Everybody on the team is coming up. You gave your USB key. Ready? All right. Everybody went through the... Oh, you want the podium? Then you never talk loud. All right, guess what? You're younger than me. You have to get it. You don't care week. Okay, your team members are here to help you, so you guys will figure it out, right? No, that you will. So I know that I saw a number of people on for the pitch training, so I'm sure you will be using all those tips that you got for your pitch training. Nobody is leaning up because that's not energy. It's not me, you know. See, your judge is here. All right, ready to get going? And just a second. All right, maybe you want to put in a good word with your judges in the meantime. Here, somebody take it out of my hand.
All of y'all need to talk.
Peach.
Are you ready? No, it's going to be up there. Sit up there. So you need two mics or you need one? Bekwe. Two mics or one? Two? All right. You need to let your judges know when you're ready, okay?
Thank you.
Let me say a final thank you in advance to our judges. We have four judges today, so we are ready to kick off. You sure you need the podium? You don't look like you're using the podium. Oh, okay, we'll rest it on it. Okay, here we go, PowerPoint. You're on.
Oh, yes.
Girl.
You have to be in there.
Okay, ladies. The judges are already taking in everything that they're seeing. And we have some prizes that are here. What it look like? Bekwe is not. You're not ready yet? Okay, turn around. Everybody turn back. Power. Turn it back now. All right. Power energy. 1, 2, 3. Right. Come now. Okay, good. Now we're ready. Okay, the videographer just wants to let you ladies know. He's asking you to stay more to this side because the more you go over to where, you can come on this side of the, exactly, you can come on this side of the banner also because this, the screen behind, which we all want to see and the judges want to see your solution, it's difficult for him to film. He can't film into it. So if he films into it, then he can't be seeing what you guys are doing. Okay? Here you go.
You know, I kind of fed up at the abusing. I fed up at this man keep hitting me all the time. I don't think it is right. It's time for it to finish. I fed up.
But you could stop then. He keep on beating you. You know, no man, no woman, no child can hit me.
You know what? It's not right, so that's why I don't want to raise back my hand.
Good afternoon, everyone. And we're representing the Beckwith Community High School. With me, I have team leader Jadicia Olivier and team members Natalia Lorraine, Alyssa Hazel, Brunel Compton, and myself. We are doing gender-based violence. Gender-based violence is a phenomenon deeply rooted in gender inequality and continues to be one of the most notable human rights violations within society.
So, this is our application. It is called ESOS, meaning Emergency SOS. We're focusing on men, children, and women because sometimes you might find men, you might think that men don't get abused, but usually they do, but they don't want to come out and say that they're being abused because maybe they might be ashamed because maybe women are abusing them.
The purpose. The need for a level playing field between men, women, and children. How it works. App installment, which basically lead to auto GPS location, then enter your contact number and enter your name. Then enter the name and number of a trusted person who you trust to know all of your business, like a family member or a friend.
Basically, the app can be downloaded, will be downloaded from the App Store, and it will be free because it should be free and accessible from to anybody, because you never know who is being abused, and not everybody could afford it if you put a price to it. After downloading the app, you have to enter the app, then press the SOS button, and it will automatically alert the nearest police station with your name, number, and your GPS location. In the event you cannot be contacted, the police will have the information of your trustee and will be able to contact them. That person may be closer in location. In the event that the person is in fear of being discovered, of the app being discovered or found by the abuser, it will also have a hidden feature where it can run as a background app. The victim can enter a 3-digit code generated by the app into the call app and press call. It will automatically send the same signal to the police so they can respond to the person.
Marketing. Free application. Free to individuals and government. Persons will become aware of the app through the following. School workshops, church groups, community awareness workshops, government interventions, social media.
Conclusion. The app will give you a feeling of security in the situation of abuse. It will give the government an opportunity to set up a program to assist the person who are abused. There can be also be a system in where individual can get support of person who have survived abuse in past.
Thank you. Okay, thank you. So that was the first pitch that was done by Bekwe. Let's give them another round of applause. Okay, and we are going to have the second team that's going to be coming up, and I'm just going to pick randomly MVAA. Yes, they are ready. We're going to see MVAA coming up. And RSC, can I get a timer, please? RSC? Anil? Amrit? Can I get a timer? Remember that your pitch is 3 minutes. So it's tight, sharp. Looks tight and sharp. Very good, ladies. You sure you want a set? Oh, for the stat. Okay, let me get out of your way. Starting, here you go. MVAA.
You do need a mic. You talking?
No.
You don't need this, right?
No, I don't need that.
This is a victim of GBV. She is worried and has no one to open up to. She just needs someone to talk to. In the Caribbean, GBV is a common case that is most of the time overlooked. But we, MVAA Girls in ICT, have created an app to help victims like her. We present to you our app, My Sister's Keeper. My Sister's Keeper is an app created to empower women and girls to also provide information on GBV and to provide counseling for GBV victims. In our app, we cater for females of all age groups. Here's just a sneak peek to our app. There are many benefits to our app for users. They will be able to express themselves anonymously, get information on GBV. They'll be also able to read quotes daily and to look at soul-lifting pictures and videos. You will be able to speak to a counselor 24 days a week, 24 hours a week, 7 days a week. Now, we've asked ourselves this question. Why should someone pay for an app that should be offered free? No one. So we've decided to create this app free. But another question pops up. How are we going to make money on this app? Well, we have come up with the most amazing idea. We've decided to sell t-shirts, cups, pens, bottles, phone cases, and a variety of things girls love in the app. But what are we going to do with the money? Should we keep it to ourselves? No. We are going to partner with the Gender Affairs Office and the Marion House in SVG to donate the money gained from this sale so that it can go to institutions to help GBV victims. Our products will be of such sophistication that people will not only buy for beautification, but also to buy for helping and supporting GBV victims. In order to get our app out there, we've decided to take it to schools and communities and to organize rallies and bring awareness of GBV to people who don't know while advertising our app and promoting and selling our products. Advertisements will also be able to, will be created to promote our app. Here's just an advertisement. Now, in St. Vincent, there is no app like this. So we, MVAA Girls, are going to make this app a reality. We present to you our app, My Sister's Keeper.
Well done, ladies. You were finished in the 3 minutes allocated time. Okay, I see a team in the back. Are you ready to come up and do your pitch? Ready to come up and do your pitch? Yes? Can we have a round of applause for the next team that's coming up, please? And this school is? Sorry? It is Girls High School. You can take the other mic because I'm going to give you two. And Intermediate High, we have a combined team. These ladies are going to be working together. I think so. One of the team members is just double checking on the USB key. Remember, you have 3 minutes for your pitch. Wow, I see it's up already. Here you go. You want to
speak to them?
Could we use?
No, we are going to.
We are going to go on the stage so that we could point out some of the stuff in press.
Boy, we're going now with the scene. How you look sad, so?
Boy, every time I go up, the manager just want to touch me up every minute.
But you ain't supposed to be glad. Is not a woman?
Yes, she's a woman, boy. I have my wife and I have my 2 children. I'm real faithful.
I could understand that. But you need to have this happy name, Better.
Better?
Better.
All the hate about this app too. This app targeting men who have problems that they can speak to professional counselors to resolve their problems.
When you think about gender-based violence, I know. The first thing that will come to your mind is gender-based violence in
women.
But as this skit just suggested, men experience it too. So today, we're here to show you that not only because they're men, and from when they're young, people instill in them, oh, boys aren't supposed to cry, you're supposed to be macho, you're supposed to be the superior sex, that you can't experience these type of things too. So we came up with a solution, Better.
When you enter the Better homepage, the first thing you will see is the homepage of the app. When you click enter, it shows you the second page that has the different problems the app focuses on. And when you click on one of the problems, it refers to the next home screen that has a drop-down menu with chats with persons of the same issues, a counselor that deals with your specific issue, exercises to deal with your emotions, facts about GBC in men, and emergency contacts for further information, and if you have emergency situations that you can't contact anybody, you don't know who to contact, especially since you're a victim of GBC and you won't know what to do, it gives you a hotline to a place such as the welfare, the police station, or other associations. The app is The app is partnering with so that we can carry out this task. Our app, we will be partnering with the Social Welfare, the Ministry of Mobilization, and other companies that deal with gender affairs in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, as there isn't any other apps like this. This is just an example of the chat page. If you so wish to chat with somebody with the same issues as yourself.
Men deserve better, to be treated better, to feel better.
Men.
Thank you very much. So that was from our combined team, and I am going to pick next team that wants to come up. You're looking at me, yes, sure. Come on. Come on. What school are we going to hear from next? I see the judges are tallying away. Yes, thank you very much for giving them a round of applause. They're double checking just to make sure that their presentation is ready. And we want to get through all of this so that we can make sure that everybody is here to participate with us for the prize giving and to recognize all your hard work. Everybody's there, you're in clear of me. You need to come this way, ladies. Come this way. Okay. All right. What school are you?
Emmanuel High School, Mesopotamia. Emmanuel High School, Mesopotamia.
Look at your eyes, pretty.
High School.
Emmanuel High School, Mesopotamia. I wonder if we have somebody here who knows that school. Your principal is here? Ha. There you go.
Questions.
Wait, we have some questions from the judges, please.
Emmanuel High, there's Emmanuel High School 1 and Emmanuel High /
We have Emmanuel High and we have Emmanuel High School Mesopotamia, RSC. They just want to verify Emmanuel. Which one?
They have 1 and there's 2.
There's Emmanuel High School 1 and Emmanuel. Okay, so this is Emmanuel High School 1. Okay. Welcome, you're going to use the podium? Okay. Come now.
Only one. No, you don't need only one. A pleasant good evening to distinguished guests, judges, principals, teachers, fellow participants, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Today, our GBV tea will be based on a blog and it is entitled Voices. V-O-I-C-E-S says victims of indecent crimes emerge as
survivors.
What is a blog all about? This is all about common safety tips on violence as a result of gender inequality and seeks to offer counsel for victims. To become a subscriber, the blog's channel, you enter your information and register using the box on the left. Registration is free. So we have the first one, which is your username. Yeah. Full name. Last name, password, and etc. Our homepage. First, we have help. After, we have support, advice, last but not least, guidance. Help. Are you in immediate danger? Are you looking for help? Please report all cases of domestic violence to Gender Affairs Division. You can contact them at 784-453-2061. Royal SVG Police Force 784-457-1211. Family Court 784-451-2477. Support. What to do if you're in an abusive relationship? You can call or contact the police. Apply for a protection order. Tell friends or your neighbors. Believe it isn't your fault. See a counselor. Click here to share your stories via chat with persons in similar situation or contact one of our certified counselors. Oh.
This is what our chat or forum will look like. Hello, what is domestic violence? Domestic violence is behavior used by a partner in an intimate relationship against the other, which causes physical, sexual, or psychological damage, or causes the other to live in fear. I think I am a victim of domestic violence. Advice. Select the video of your choice. The video that is going to be played is giving you information on safety during an abusive incident, safety when preparing to leave, warning signs of abuse, what to do if you're in an abusive relationship. Videos give a more intimate reaction and makes it appear that the person is in a real-time conversation with the user. Guidance. Am I in an abusive relationship? Does your partner have a bad temper? Yes or no? Do you live in fear of your partner? Is your partner unpredictable? Are you afraid they may kill you? Do you feel emotionally numb? Do they tell you that you cause him or her to abuse you or your children? Do you feel that there is nowhere to turn to for help? Do they embarrass you, harass you, criticize you in front of others? Does your partner abuse you verbally? Does your partner lie about his or her behavior? If your score returns with more than 5 checked off and you wish to seek further help, contact our counselors by clicking below help on homepage. Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was great work, teamwork coming there together. I think we have this team here that is ready to pitch now. Are you ready to pitch, ladies? Yes, you're ready, man. Come, the teacher say you're ready to pitch. Teacher says you are ready to pitch. Let's have a round of applause for the next team that is going to be coming up. And I've lost track, but I have to tell you that I'm very, very much must applaud you for completing your pitches within the 3-minute time frame. So you've definitely done a very good job on that. You're going to be going up. Yeah, you can go up if you want to. Just me and you, counselor, up on the stage. Here you go. Oh, sorry, I didn't get the name of your school. North Union Secondary School is now doing the pitch. Okay.
Abuse, me can't take abuse. Can't take this boy.
Girl, are we wrong with you?
Girl, every minute my boyfriend beating me up. I can't take this anymore.
So why you not go to a counselor?
People love too much of comments, man. Can't take them there. Mm-mm.
Good afternoon. My name is Moriah Williams, and along with me are my group members, Sabria Neversons, Shafia Straw, Ashanta Thomas, and Anelia Lave.
Our solution for this problem is JMYC. What is it? It is an artificial intelligence that performs the role of a counselor. You talk to it and it responds to you.
This is how it will look in the future, JMYC.
Why is this app important? Trust and confidence. That's two things that are rare today. It's hard even to talk to your parents today, and counselors are slowly becoming obsolete as nothing you tell them seems to stay in the room. And those that take advantage of you and your trust are just pushing it too far. So here's the solution. Just me and you, counselor.
Features. A sign up page. You can personalize the interface. You can switch button text and voice. You can record a personal message to be forwarded to your parents in an event you have some news to tell them or you are afraid to talk to them face to face. The app can sense when you are not feeling well based on your speech patterns.
In terms of security, in order to access the app, you have to use a PIN, a voice command, or a fingerprint. Messages and voice note will be encrypted. After 1 to 3 minutes of inactivity, the app closes. In the event that AI app does not hear from you in about 2 to 3 days, it can alert someone to check upon you. The person it will contact will be set up in the sign-up process.
Functional and reliability. It will require Wi-Fi connection in the case where there is no Wi-Fi connection. These can be made with digital offload to allow the app to access their cell signals to communicate with no charges being applied. In the event that the AI cannot respond to you, to a statement or a question, it will send a signal to a call center where psychologists will be on call to respond to you. Thank you for watching.
Often as I put up this sign, it just drops back down. So how many are we gone now? How many? Judges? How many? Four. Okay, that means we have four more to go. So can I see the next team that is ready? Thank you very much. That was a great job, North Union. Can I see the next team that is ready to pitch? Okay, I'm going to pick Emmanuel High School too. Can you come up, please? Emmanuel High School 2. They are ready to do their pitch. You have two mics. Come. You can do it here, you know. Who? Your technical gentleman is speaking to you. He needs to just make sure that he has your presentation ready. Okay, and just remind us again the name of the school, even though I have it already.
Emmanuel High School, Mesopotamia. Hey, President, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and fellow competitors. Today, our topic would be on gender-based violence. Violence against women. Violence against women is one of the most prevalent human rights issues in the world. Here in St. Vincent, it is no different. I am sure if I were to go from table to table today, everyone can at least identify one female which is or might have been a victim of abuse. And for this cause, we choose to create a solution. Today we are bringing to you Save Me app. Gender-based violence is violent against women and terms that are often used interchangeably, as it has been widely acknowledged the most gender-based violence is inflicted on women and girls by men. Types of gender-based violence: physical, emotional, and sexual. Causes of gender-based violence are poverty, lack of educational level, weakness of laws, and women's low position in society. Our solution. The Save Me app. The Save Me app is an app created for women that are in distress. You click, it is at easy command. It's an app that is free. You can get it on Google Play Store. The app gives you, sorry, I'm not feeling well. The app gives you options. The app gives you options. Each option is a profile, a Track Me. If you click the Track Me, it would automatically turn on your GPS location. So if you're in distress, someone can locate you. A Contact app, where you can contact your parents if you're a child and you're in danger. An Emergency app, if you're beaten badly or wounded and you have no other place to turn, you can click on the app. It would automatically go to a medical care center, which would send an alert to a hospital. It can also be a stranger danger app, which could lead to the police. It can also be a GBV alert, as I said, when you're beaten, that would lead to the Ministry of Mobilization. Today, we thank you for listening to us. The app would be provided on Google Play Store. It is free of charge. I thank you. Say no to gender-based violence.
Okay, we're seeing some excellent graphics that are taking place here. I think the judges are going to be quite challenged. I think we have two teams that are left. Team here in the front is ready to go. And what school are you from? Oh, go to the next team because they're still having a little issue downloading. Challenge downloading. The next team, we have one team that is left. Our combined team, please come. Please come. And our combined team, I think we have IHS. Right, what other schools do we have? Mountain View, and what's the third one? It's three different teams you're from, right, all together? And, everybody talk. Emmanuel, there you go. All right, ladies, you're up. So you're all set with them, Annie? All right. We're going to have this team present. You're going to go up also to climate alert. Here you go.
Good afternoon, everyone. We are a mixed team comprised of three schools, Emmanuel High School, Mountain View Adventist Academy, and the Intermediate High School. Together, we have created a website or blog where people can take actions and contribute to aid in the environment and help those whose lifestyles have been drastically affected by climate change.
So here on our app, we have the homepage, which has the title, which is Climate Alert, and the slogan, bringing you the latest news on climate change. And then we have our blog, where our first post is the awareness walk. We'll be posting things like events we'll have to raise funds for those who have been affected and to find ways where we can stop it. And we have our contact info, and we are the headquarters. And this one is a walk where we walk from one place to the other, hand out tracts, and raise awareness about climate change and the ways we can stop it. Then we have our About Us. And in here we tell what is our aim, who we are, and why we started this. Then we have, we have the suggestions and comments and opinions. Here people can voice their opinions on how they think we can help others and what we can do as a team to, and events we should do to raise funds. And then we have donations. Here you can donate online, and you can, here we have this section here where you can donate an amount, and it can't be cheap because it will not allow you, but if something like $5 or $100,000 or $1,000, it will give you how to do it. It will take your information, your credit scores and everything, so that you can make the online payments. And that is our app. You can post your opinions and everything on the blog to say how we can help and aid in climate change, and look out for events that you can join us and make a difference.
Thank you. That is from our combined team. I think we see a great job in terms of the teams pulling together spontaneously. Again, using some excellent graphics. RSC, how are we? We have half a second. Who can count half a second? Who can count half a second? Okay, so we have a few things that we're going to be doing while the judges are doing their final tabulation. So we have one last team, which is going to, somebody need, they need some help. They need some help. We have one last team that is going to be doing their presentation with just sorting out, getting it on the USB keys. And as well, what we're going to do is that we have questionnaires.
So they're not listed. Mm-hmm. Right? So
we have some questionnaires that we need you to complete. So this is what we're going to do. As a matter of fact, I think we can actually get started, but we want you still to be giving keen attention when the last team is doing their pitch. Okay? So we have some desktops here on the left. We have another bay here beside Kevin, and another one here beside Akeem. RSC, are we using this bank of computers as well too? Are we using this one here that we can see the back of? One, two, three. Okay, so starting from the back of the room, everybody that has on a Seagirls Hack t-shirt, can you please go? We're gonna have our mentors to assist you. You're gonna be completing the questionnaire, right? But also give keen attention. You're not going to lose the attention of the room. Okay? All right. Huh? Yes, you see these guys are ready to go. They're called Pitch Tech WeMate. I think that's a super name. Are we ready to go, RSC? Yes? Okay. All right. So they are up. You can sit by the stations to start to complete your questionnaires. And I'm gonna ask the other teams to stay in place. And once they are finished doing their pitch, and we've given them a round of applause. What school are you from? They are from...
No, your mic isn't on yet.
Oh, praise God. Y'all, catch me if I jump.
They are from Intermediate High. Okay?
Sorry.
Go, 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 go.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Roshanti Lewis. This is Alicia Batiste, Sherisia Isaacs, Nelika Roberts, and Jelona Charles. We basically based our pitch point on a death of one of our past students, Kahalia Lockhart, as you can see. Well, she had asthma. We want to invent an app that really tells us how the weather is. So, Zelisha.
The app is based on Kahalia because she had asthma and this app will let you know how to be better prepared for the weather, and it can help, help with your health issues like asthma and your sinus, because we have a problem with the Sahara dust, so it can affect most people from asthma, who have asthma. So the app can help you to remind you to always walk with your asthma puff in case of anything. And also your sinus, because most people are affected by sinus, and also from pollens, because when wind blows, it raises the pollen, so that can also affect you. What it does, the app basically based on weather, based on location. So when you download the app, it will let you know, like show you how to place in your direction and let you know where you're living. Like, for instance, if you're living in country, in Kingston, so the information should be right. And it's also protect
yourself.
Inform you about ways to protect yourself. So let you know how outside is, what you should wear, when to walk with water, if you're dehydrated, if the sun is very hot. And it gather data from users about change in weather in their location, as I said before, if you're living in country or Kingston. Work with partners such as Vinleg and CWSA. So if there is a power outage, it will let you know that we have a power outage, or if you should lock off your, they are going to lock off your water and you should fill up water or something like that. And WeMade is actually the name of the app. If you will want to know why we give it that name, you can ask. But
can be your best mate in the age of climate change,
and that's our
presentation.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you, team. So, do we have any team that has not done their pitch? Sorry, just eating a little sugar. A sweet cookie. We have any team that's not finished their pitch? Silence, so that means no. So, anybody that's sitting in the back that has on a Seagirls Hack t-shirt, please, I need you to come to the, I need you to come to the screens on the side. So this is what you're going to do. You're being assisted by the mentors. Can we have another mentor on this side here, O'Shea? There's a station at the front. Yeah. Can we have another mentor here on the side? So as soon as you're finished, Akeem, in case they need any help there. As soon as you're finished doing your questionnaire,
please, if you can return to your group, because we're going to have the next round of young ladies who are also going to sit. So what is happening now is that the judges, you see they're holding their heads, they're considering, they're debating, they're talking. I said every presentation was so well done, so interesting. They see a lot of the research. We know you're nervous. Don't worry about it. Everybody here is a winner because remember that this is about a learning experience. Yes? It's about a learning experience. So we are just so glad that you all have been here with us today. And what we're going to do now is that we're going to let the judges do their tabulation. Teams on the side, I think some of you should be finishing up now with the questionnaire. The mentors can help you to run through it. I see a free space there. Vakel, do you have any free spaces there? She has two free spaces there on the side, right? Two free spaces on the side. And in the meantime, I'm going to speak with some of you to get your, opinions, because we also have what we call testimonials. So we're going to get your opinions. I'm just going to just go around the room and just get your opinions. You need to stand where this gentleman can see you. Is this good, Mr. Cap? Okay. So what was a high point? What was a low point? Or just what was interesting about today for you? And if you can tell us your name and what school you're from.
My name is Crystal Francis, and I'm from the Moncton View Adventist Academy. Well, today, one of the high points for us was when we had the feedbacks from the first pitch to go and put in, and that was one of the high points for us for today.
Okay.
And for our low point today...
Oh, she didn't have any low points. Oh, that's good. That's good. So tell us a little bit about your expectations of the day and how you feel about today.
Today was a really good day. We had a lot of fun, I believe, from my team members. We had a lot of fun. And they went out and they did other stuff and get the chance to relax their mind finally.
Okay, excellent. Thank you. So that's MVAA that we heard from. Great. So while they're doing the tabulation, I also want to hear from some other schools. Where are our Beckwith girls? I think they're filling out the questionnaires. Yes, Beckwith girls are filling out the questionnaires. I know you're a mentor. I know you're a mentor. Cheyenne. No, this is, yes. Yes and no. You did the pre-hackathon survey already. Oh, so you should be doing the post on. We're going to follow up with you afterwards to do the post-hackathon survey. Well, we have a lot of girls who are, come and talk to me and tell me about what you learned today. Come. Oh, and guess what? You don't even have to go far. You know what? I'm shy too. Come. All right, you know what? Two of you, both of you at one time, so no one person stand up. Anybody that has on a t-shirt came here to hack and was hacking. So tell me what you think about, tell me your name and the school that you're from.
My name is Francine Brown. I'm from the Joshua Secondary School.
Okay, great, Francine. And you are?
Gianna Gibbs from Intermediate High School.
Okay, so we have Gianna and we have Francine. And let me hear, what were your views on today?
Wait.
She said she's laughing, so it was great. Okay, let me hear from you.
I believe with the Caribbean Girls Hack, it's very important because those young ladies out there who really need help, they can actually get help from this program that is going on.
Okay, great. So you found that it was useful for you today. All right, let's hear from you. She's laughing, which is a good thing. It's not a bad thing. How was it today? Did you learn anything today? What did you learn? Okay, stand up behind me and tell me. What you learn?
It's very important that you share alone.
You don't have to look at the mic at all. Forget about the mic. Just talk to me. She said she learned that it's very important that you share and learn.
I can't talk anymore.
No, forget about the mic. Just talk to me. You're talking to my ear. See me here?
And you create. Let me see everything out there.
Yes. Very important that you learn and share and you create. I'm listening.
Ideas.
You don't need to cover your mouth. And you get ideas. Two.
Wait. It's very important that you learn and share about different ideas to inspire girls.
To inspire girls, okay. Ideas to inspire girls. Thank you very much. Okay. You're going to fill out the questionnaire afterwards. Thank you very much. So let's hear from some of our ladies here at this table here. This lady's on her phone, so I know that she's actually testing out one of the apps that was developed today. Can you tell us what school you're from and what you felt from the experience you had here today?
I am from the girls' high school, and I think that this was very informative. It helps our girls to communicate with each other and, you know, share our thoughts on gender-based violence and, you know, enhance what we know that we can use this in our everyday lives. So if this has to happen to us, we can say, oh, I learned that from this activity, so I can use it now.
I think Miss Kwame Harry will be very happy to hear that you have a student. What school are you again?
Girls High School.
Girls High School is on board. Thank you very much. I think we're going to be going across the room now where we don't have anybody with their head on the table. Come, Caroline. Caroline says she wants me to identify her. Come, Caroline. Come now, you have to stand up beside me. Okay, just talk to me now. Come. Oh, God. All right, so I want to hear a loud cheer if you guys had a good time today. Did you have a good time today? We didn't hear from any of the Beckway students. I have one Beckway student here. She's going to tell us what her experience was like today. And tell us your school, remember, please.
I'll hold it. Okay, thank you. I'm from the Beckway Community High School. My experience today was very good. It was actually better than I expected.
Oh, good.
And I enjoyed myself, and I'm looking forward to coming and looking on the next time.
Okay, she had more fun than she expected. And what we are doing also, just to let all of you know, so we had videos that we had shared with you of actually what took place at the hackathon in Jamaica. So St. Vincent is the second country out of 5 countries in the Caribbean. So you have also continued to keep the bar very high. So what we're also going to be doing is we're going to be going on to Grenada, where we're going to be sharing with the girls there about what you all did today as well. They're going to see you. We're not going to show them your presentations until after they finish at the end of the day, because we don't want to give them any tips, right? Right. So, but they're going to see the highlights from what you did today, and we're going to continue sharing that, and then you also will be able to. Everybody knows that they can go to our YouTube page, Sea Girls Hack, where you can see Caribbean Girls Hack and Sea Girls Hack, where you can see more information about empowerment videos, about other presentations that have been done. I think we're ready for another round of questionnaires to be completed. Are we ready for another round of questionnaires to be completed? I think the judging is coming to a close, so we're going to be moving on to the next round. Thank you. Right, we have another station that is taking place here. As we have some free spots, mentors, can you just let us know? Okay, 2 free spots over here to the left. Everybody that is in the back that has on a Sea Girls Hack shirt, can you come forward, please? Can you come forward and sit with the group so that we know we have our observers that are in the back? Okay, thank you. have Vakel, Ciel, Natalie. Did I say it correct?
No.
Janelle, Natalie, Okeisha. We're our other mentors. Janaya, exactly. And we have your teachers. You have to give a big round of applause to your teachers. Big, big round of applause to your teachers. We also have three principals who are here with us. We have the principal of MVAA. We have the principal of Georgetown. We have the principal of EHMS. Exactly. And we have with us, come back for the awards, we have Ms. LaFleur Kwame Harry from the Bureau of Gender Affairs within the ministry. And we have other colleagues that are also here that she's going to tell us about. So thank you very much for coming and supporting the hard work that these ladies have been doing. Another round of applause for your teachers, I think, right? And also, we can't leave here today without giving a round of applause for your judges. We need to give a round of applause for the judges. And I can see that RSC is ready to kick off. Mr. Sunil John from IT Solutions is here. So let us have a round of applause for him also, to please. Exactly. Super. Thank you. All right. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to hand over to RSC and we're going to get going because I think they have the tabulation that is ready for us now.
It's all tabulated.
It's all tabulated. You are going to speak with the mic as well.
Okay, so the moment we have been waiting on for the past couple weeks, it has been an exciting journey. I know at times a challenging journey. I know some of you all had a good day today. Some of you all had a super day today. Some of you all had moments that I know the mentors had to come around and support. So first thing from RSC, I'd like to say congratulations from the whole organization. Congratulations to all of you all. From our side, it's really nice to see you in person because I know through the webinars you have been seeing us and hearing us. And as we call the different categories first, just remind you the prizes. We are going to have categories for teams. So we have the best organized team, the best social media team, the best capacity build team, and the best idea. And you will all receive prizes for that. And then we'll go to the top three winners. Nicole will be guiding you as to what the teams really will be getting for these. So are you ready? All right, so
I don't know, Raj. I don't know if Anil is giving us that drum roll.
God.
Are you giving us that drum roll?
So the first we're gonna call, and do we have someone to present it? Yes,
Natalie here,
is presenting.
Ready to rock and roll.
So, students, ladies and gentlemen, the first category is best capacity build. And this was given based on your attendance for webinars, training, and capacity building. And this went to St. Vincent Girls High School. Do we have anyone from the team St. Vincent Girls High School? I know you didn't have a full team to present, so please come on, St. Vincent. There's only one girl there here today. Come on, St. Vincent
Girls High School.
Give them a round of applause. This is the team, the school that was consistent with webinars for St. Vincent and the Grenadines.
Okay.
So they're being presented with their medals.
Your name?
Zerise Williams.
Okay, Zerise, congratulations.
Trudy Kosh.
Trudy, you said? Okay. And?
Adonis.
Okay, congratulations to them.
So, quick photo shoot with them. And where's Mr. Graves? Thompson, give Mr. Graves a round of applause, our President of the Caribbean Association of Principals.
Okay.
And our best capacity bill. I saw the life. All right, so the next category, we move on quickly.
Excellent, congrats.
And there were different categories and stuff we had to do before the event, and you are being observed today during the event. The best organized team. Anil, are we ready? Best organized team, and also goes through like with best effort. Best organized team is Beckway Community High School. Beckway Community High School.
Yes, Beckway made such an effort. They completed everything that needed to be done.
And for those of you who attended the webinars, you know the points of this. It was based on effort. It's based on what you filled out. You're bringing in your QR codes today. The activities you were done that led up to the competition today.
Okay. You can give it to them also. Come girls, fan out so that we can give everybody quickly. Congratulations for your hard work. Whoops. I can't go on either side. Mr. RSC, will you please join us? Congratulations.
All right, and we move on again.
Thank you very much.
We had a category called social media, where you were supposed to submit pictures for the Facebook and also your tweets. Social media, Anil. The best social media category went to Mountain View Adventist Academy. Mountain View Academy. Come on up, come on up. And they won the category best social media.
Okay, here we go.
Together. Here you go,
Cheyenne. Here you go. All right, let's get a photo with our best social media category ladies.
Are we all good?
Congratulations, a round of applause for them again.
And okay. There was a category called best idea. And this was a subcategory of the overall winners. The best idea, and the reason why this category came out is because not always the best idea is the winning team, because you have the other categories that add to it, like tree planting, social media, podcasting, capacity build. Best idea based on today's judging, best idea went to Mountain View Academy. Mountain
wow.
View Academy, Adventist Academy,
Mountain
and you are
View
coming back again.
Extra gold.
So come on up with your medals and take another strong next tonight. Super congratulations to Mountain View.
And I know you see that your medals indicate Caribbean Girls Hack on them. So guess what? You get another photo up. Boy, let me tell you, paparazzi here.
All right, so now we go on to...
So, big round of applause for all of our best categories. And RSC is moving on to give us our next.
So, our overall third place winner, which was based on what you did today in presentation. Our third place winner was a combined team. Third place winner was a combined team. St. Vincent Girls High and Intermediate High, our combined team, third place winner. Please come on up.
Winners.
Third place winners, St. Vincent Girls High combined with Intermediate High. Round of applause again for our third place winners. And
so our third place winners receive a Fitbit prize as well as your medals. And in addition to that, let's see if Javian is here.
Is Javian here? No,
I don't look like Javian is here. Congratulations again. Can we have an applause for the third place winners? Very good. Wow, look, she has so many prizes already. Oh, this is excellent. So in addition to that, you also win a free voucher from Russell's Cinema. That's valid for 1 month. So let me just clarify. It's valid for 1 month. It's not that you can keep coming for 1 month. Okay? And unfortunately, Javier is not here with us, but we'll make sure that your teacher has that information. And the prizes are Fitbits that all of you have received in your gift bags. Congrats again.
Our second place winner.
Okay, second place winner is coming up now.
Second place winner. Caribbean Girls Hack
2019.
You want to tell them one time what the prize is?
Or? I don't know. I mean, but what I want to more focus on is what was the solution they came up with. Maybe that could be a tip.
What was the solution? A tip. Oh my gosh.
Let us see. The judges had quite a challenge.
All right. Second place was also a combined team. Second place, the combination of Emmanuel High, Mountain View, and Intermediate High School.
Oh,
second
wow.
place, Emmanuel High, Mountain View High, and Intermediate
team.
High School.
Second place. Winners. Super. I have your silver medals with you here. And you also win headsets, right? Headsets. Rosetta, congratulations. Somebody hasn't gotten one yet. Okay, we can go a little to the side here so we can get you. Well done. Okay, and the second place winners, you also win a 1 month gift voucher from Russell Cinema, and your teacher will get that information. No, but it's teachers, because it's a combined team.
It's a combined team.
Team. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're down to the final drum roll.
Caribbean Girls Hack 2019, St. Vincent and the Grenadines.
And can I ask IT Solutions to come
Caribbean
down front,
Girls
please?
Hack 2019, St. Vincent and Grenadines, principals, mentors, judges, students. Our winner for St. Vincent and Grenadines 2019 is Mountain View Adventist Academy.
Yes,
Mountain View
well
Adventist Academy. Come on up, and a huge round of applause to them. Everybody, I would agree, y'all was super impressive, and attitude today super impressive, and attendance
well done,
before super
well
impressive
done.
With what you presented today.
And thank you to our judges. Okay, so can we have the principal? Can we have the principal for Mountain View Academy?
Principal is here, yes.
The principal is here, Mr. Bowman. Can we have
round of applause
front,
for
please?
The principal of our winning team 2019.
And our students from MVAA also win Bluetooth speakers. Yes. And we have the principal is coming down. We have Mr. Sunil John, who is here also to present you with
Our gifts. Good afternoon, everyone. Our gifts, the gift vouchers from IT Solutions. And before I came here, I was told that there's actually a confirmed gift, which is a bit more valuable than this. But when you make contact with us, then we'll let you to know what it is. Right? So congratulations again.
All right, so thank you very much, Sunil and
okay,
IT Solutions.
So each person gets an awarded gift from IT Solutions, Mr. Sunil John. Congratulations. Thank you very much, IT Solutions. Can you please stay with us for the photo also? Okay, so and can we have all our teachers from MVAA with us?
Teachers,
yes.
Yes, come on. Round
thank
of applause
for
the hard working teacher today.
Yes, thank you very much. C- congratulations once again, and thanks to IT Solutions. Remember, IT Solutions, Mr. John says you're to get in touch with him. Thank you very much. Everybody would like to hear a loud cheer from everybody who was here participating today. A loud cheer. I know everybody is so tired, but not before we're finished. We need to let you know also that we also have certificates for everybody that we should have been handing out to everybody. So don't leave without your certificates. We're going to ask you to come up as your teams. And Vakil, are we ready? Yeah? Which one you want to start with first? We can start. As a matter of fact, we can do two because I know some people have. Yeah. We can do two sections at the same time. So we have a certificate of participation. Eh? What? No, just bring it here and we're gonna hand them to them. But you can bring two sets at a time. You can come with another set at the same time. Thank you. You can come with another, be careful there. Come Raj, because we have the Mountain View, can we ask you to come back so you can get your awards, please?
We have the Mountain View.
Natalia.
No, this.
Oh no, this one is Bekwe.
Okay.
So Bekwe, can you come and receive your certificates of participation, please? Everybody from the team can come. You probably won't end up with the right certificate in your hand, but we want to. Mr. RSC, can you help us to pass out the awards to all our girls? Yes, so as I said, you may not get the right award in your hand, but Isabella. I can't tell you what it really is. I can only tell you. Okay. Like. Just give it. Right now, Brunel. I can't breathe. Good. Alyssa. Who looks just like Alyssa in Jamaica. Jadisha. But we need to get a picture of the whole team together with your certificate. Quick.
Intermediate is next.
Okay, so the photographer is giving us paparazzi instructions now. Okay. Step forward. Intermediate high school, please. Can we have intermediate high school? Is intermediate gone? Intermediate is here in the house. We want to give you your certificates of participation. Please accept that. We don't want to keep everybody here long, so I might give you the wrong name, but you can sort it after, right? And Roshante. And if you can turn so that the cameraman. Oh, but you were in the other team. Rosetta, come. We're going to write up one for Rosetta.
All right.
We need to have one written. You'll get it. You'll get it right now. Okay? Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. All right. And the next group that we have is... Can you just write one? Oh, you're on the mixed team. You can't get two certificates. Joke, it's me. I made the mistake. Rosetta, we give it to you with the mixed team, Rosetta. Emmanuel team two. Right, Emmanuel team two. Emmanuel team two, ladies. Thank you. You can come this way and just collect your certificate and just, yes, stand to the side. Yes, we give it to the right person. Okay, and the gentleman who is taking our pictures is over here. Make sure you get. Yes, and you can switch after. Because he wants you to curve a bit. He wants you to curve you a bit this way here. He wants you to face this way here. Okay. Okay, congratulations, thank you. And our next team that we are presenting to is?
Emmanuel and North Union combined.
Emmanuel and North Union combined. Round of applause for Emmanuel and North Union combined team, please. Right, we want to give you your certificates of participation. And if you can just stand to the side here. You spread out too far, I think. Thank you very much, combined team again. We have the next Emmanuel team that we need to give you your certificate of participation. The next Emmanuel team, can you come up, please? Everybody waiting on you in the back way. People waiting on you. Thank you very much. Come, you can come this side here. Can you step back a little bit? Can you step back a little bit? We want to get some of the banner in there also. There you go. Well, stand up. Okay, thank you. Oh, you want the picture with Rosetta? But Rosetta is on the other team.
GHS and Intermediate.
No, that's another combined group. Can you come for your certificate of participation, please? And we really applaud you girls for working together, bringing that team spirit, bringing that idea of really working together as a team, being flexible and to make those changes to do that. Okay. Congrats, we have another team that is coming up, and this is intermediate now. Is this a combined team? This is intermediate high. Who is a combined team? Intermediate high. Yes, come Rosetta. This is your team now. School, she hasn't left you. She's still with you, but she just knows how to work together with other schools, right? Yes. Yes, it don't matter, you will. We will give it, guess what, we have one with your name on it. We don't want to delay the Congratulations again, everybody. Make sure you give the right person. And now we have the final one for Georgetown. Georgetown, no, we have two sets to give now. We have Georgetown and, what is this one? Okay, let me hold on to the Mountain View. We have Georgetown, we have Mountain View. Do we have another set? Okay. Georgetown, did Georgetown leave already? Does anybody know if Georgetown left? Georgetown is here. Can you please come and get your certificates, please? This one was which one? This is Georgetown? This is Mountain View. Oops. Let me tell you, no matter what I do with this piece of banner, it just dropped down. What can I tell you? Eh? I think I will let it sleep. I'm tired. Congratulations. He wants us to go around a little bit more. Right, there you go. Excellent. And then we have our final school, which I think the mentors said to me, this is for the winning team. Mountain View, please. Can we have Mountain View? And then actually what I'd like to do is I'd like to get everybody with, remember, it don't matter if I give you the wrong one. I'd like to get everybody with their certificates. Everybody has received their certificates. I'm going to ask you now if you can just come up all as one big group. And we also would like to recognize, just put it up flat because it's not staying up. We would like to recognize the work of all our mentors that have worked so hard. So we have Travis Kane. Travis Kane, are you here with us? Can we have a round of applause for Travis? I know the mentors were working hard to make sure that the solutions were very well done. Thank you very much, Travis. Thank you. And then we have Renson Dumfrey. Renson Humphrey. Oh my gosh. No, you know what? And I saw that, right? Guess what? I was the one saying the wrong name. Sorry. Thank you. Okay. And mentors, we don't want you to go too far, you know, because we're going to take one big group picture now. And there's Rafiq Jackson. Is Rafiq here with us? Rafiq is with which school? He's with intermediate, so we're going to leave it with his students in the meantime. Thank you. All right, and we have Jasine John. Jasine John. Oh, round of applause for Jasine. Let me tell you, podcasters, problem solving, solution, everything. Okay, and we have Kenora Bino. All right, so last but not least, we have to recognize our judges and our mentors, volunteers, Natalie, Vakel, O'Shea. I got that wrong. Okisha. I know when I was saying it that I got it wrong. Natalie Constance. I'm going to have all the mentors all together. Thank you. So if you can come. And we're going to take a picture all together. Don't mind that it's blank, right? Come up your hand. Judges, can you please also join us? We'd like to recognize your hard work. Girls, you need to give a huge round of applause for your mentors and judges. Yes, some people can come around this side. Natalie Wood, I mean.
I'm sorry. I can keep us some company over here.
Okay, so before our judges and mentors disappear, Vakel, just stay right here. We would like to get everybody, the whole entire room, and we're going to take one photo. We're going to do it, how shall we do it, Mr. Cameraman? Across the front here, you still want us on a sort of...